Welcome back to George Square in Glasgow. How can you compete with the last few hours? It has been such a sensational day. Well, it all just keeps getting better and better because the quality is going up all the time. This is the men's plate third place playoff.
Thank you. And now for Costa Rica.
Here we go between Costa Rica and Namibia. It will prove to be a very good match indeed. And that's for third and fourth place. But over on pitch two, there have been some sensational goals so far between Northern Ireland and South Africa. And that game is on the stream for pitch two. And Tom Crosby is commentating on that match. Northern Ireland leading by 3-2 right now, with 6 minutes played, so approaching half-time there. And we are getting ready to get underway here. Pitch one has been the place to be for all the drama so far. It's been where the prizes have been dished out. Four of them so far, the Czech Republic, Cambodia, Wales, and Bulgaria getting their hands on silverware. This is a battle for third place in the plate competition, the second tier tournament. Costa Rica were defeated in the last round by Ireland, who will play in the final straight after this against Egypt. Egypt defeated Namibia in the quarter-final, and then Namibia went on to defeat Northern Ireland. This has been such a tightly contested competition so far. Expect exactly the same from now on. On the field for Costa Rica, Luis Campos. Justin Rojas is the number 3, and number 7 is Luis Chavarria. This is Campos, and it sneaks through. For Namibia, we have Eduardo Iseb. Also number five, who is the danger man, Jarman Ripunda. And number three is Rian Swartebui. The goalkeeper is Kelvin Kok for Namibia. So there will be a free kick here for the African side. Africa versus Central America for this one. And another intriguing contrast of styles and the way that either side tries to get the better of their opposition. It's well played though by Campos. And here's the danger man, Rojas, who was on fire when Costa Rica defeated Scotland here on pitch one on Friday. Strike coming in from Campos. Rojas. Chavarria is free over the other side, but the pass back, and it was hit by Ripunda. Good save by Jose Torres, the goalkeeper for Costa Rica. And he's down now, but that didn't stop him from making the save up against Rian Swartebui. Now that should come the way of Kelvin Kok. He's had a fine tournament. The Namibia number one, I should say. The effort coming in by the captain, Eduardo Iseb. This is Chavarria and Rojas, but just having to go back and filter in is Campos. And Namibia have it. A hammered shot, but just too high from number two, Iseb. Calm down, says Luis Diego Campos. Plenty of the Latin countries adopt the calmer approach. Possession of the football is key. The opposition cannot hurt you if they don't have the ball. That's the mentality, and they all trust in their supreme technical abilities. Well, Justin Rojas just unable to get into the contest so far. Here's Iseb for Namibia. Iseb to Ripunda. The strike lacking the connection that was required from Swartebui. This time, Tess Torres in goals. Namibia yet to trouble the scorers. Costa Rica that have the lead. Iseb, the captain. And that's a great effort. Fine strike by Rian Swartebui. We're all leveled up. Costa Rica's advantage cancelled out by the number three for Namibia. Jose Chacon has taken to the field for Costa Rica. He's the number five. He's up on the right-hand side and now switching over to the left to receive the ball now. That should be Kelvin Cox's ball. Ripunda. That's nicely worked. Swartebui! Two quick goals for Namibia, and they now lead this contest. Two minutes left to play of the half. Just over. Ripunda. That's nicely done by Iseb. Back to Ripunda. Well, it didn't look like there was a gap there, but he found a way past Jose Armando Torres. Swartebui. Torres just having to be careful there, not to let the ball go outside of his area. Here's Chacon. And he's got two Namibians for company there. Coming away with it is Iseb. And Chacon won't quite catch that one. Caught. Great ball. Rapunda. Great feet. Well, one of them was either inside or outside the box. That should have been an intervention from the officials, but play on. There's a chance for Svartbui. Rojas into Chacon. Free kick goes against Rapunda and hammered home. And that was an important goal by Luis Diego Campos. Namibia have their lead cut. Vital for Costa Rica that they didn't allow a three-goal difference. Even at this stage, we've seen in these finals, they are much tighter than those earlier group games. And good work by Chacon, but won back well by Iseb. Svartbui now. And Iseb. Svartbui. Looked to thread it through, but there was no gap for the number three. And Campos managing to keep a hold of the ball despite being on his knees. Oh, so unfortunate from Jose Chacon. Off the inside of the post, and up come Namibia. Flying challenges coming in from Chacon. And here he is now on the ball, back to his goalkeeper, Jose Torres. Looking to find the feet there of Campos. Chacon, Rojas, just losing his footing. Does become difficult when that surface is wet. Very difficult to stay on your feet unless you have the right footwear on. And that is the half-time whistle. Well, that came out of nowhere. Namibia leading Costa Rica by 3-2 at the break. Well, we can go back over to pitch 2 just to have a look between Northern Ireland and South Africa. It is ticking down the seconds there. 25 seconds to go, and it is looking good for the men from Northern Ireland. That is such a strong South African side, but Northern Ireland, who were beaten by the Namibians, who are leading here against Costa Rica, but they are by no means out of it. Plenty still to play for as these two teams face up to see who will finish third in the plate competition. Of course, these are the teams that will contest between positions 9 and 16 of the Homeless World Cup. And that was Rian Svartbui, who contributed a couple of key goals for Namibia, and that is why they have a lead by 3-2. But Luis Diego Campos is rallying his troops, the captain for Costa Rica, trying to get one last big effort. And 7 minutes left to play for Costa Rica and Namibia. None of these players want their tournament to end, but it has to at some point. Chacon to Rojas, across to Campos, and this is Chacon once more. And Northern Ireland triumphing over South Africa by 7-4, just as Namibia fire in another goal to go 4-2 up. And it's that man, Rian Svartbui, once more. Justin Rojas now. Rojas again, and if he could have found Chacon over on the far side, he will have the chance now. But he's just off target. That's great play initially by Campos. He couldn't add the finish, though. The next goal's big. If it goes the way of Namibia, you would strongly fancy them from there. Costa Rica will be determined not to let that happen. Svartboy has it now. Rapunda loses out. Big chance. And Justin Rocas, who has had hardly a sniff at goal all game, he is one of the top finishers here. And he gets a goal in the third, fourth place playoff. Now, he was outside the box. That goal does count. And Justin Rocas is just finding his form at the right time. And Tom Crosby hot footing it over from pitch two is back in the commentary box here in pitch one. How was that for the boys from Northern Ireland? A great victory over South Africa.
Well,
Tom,
it was the double act yet again. Sterritt and Spears, they controlled that game. 8-4 to Northern Ireland over South Africa. South Africa did all they could, but the tackling was too hard and the finishing too sublime for Northern Ireland.
And as you can see, it is finally poised here on pitch one between Namibia and Costa Rica. Namibia had the advantage, Tom, but Costa Rica have come back into it, and it's the number three, Justin Rocas, who scored a couple of important goals. But Namibia now re-establish a lead, and it's their key man, Jarmin Rapunda, with the goal.
Rapunda's been so strong throughout the tournament. We've seen games on pitch one where he scored four or five times himself.
Svartboy, and there's been a change for Costa Rica in goals. It's Fabian Alvarez now, the number 13, who takes his place. Kelvin Kok, as always, in his position for Namibia, but it is another one to peg them back from Costa Rica. Luis Diego Campos, the captain, leading by example.
He was so calm, so controlled. I've hot-footed it away from a strong, powerful game to walk straight into one. So finely poised as this. Don't forget, we will go to penalties should this be even at half at full time. But the number two for Namibia is pinging that one in from nowhere.
Eduardo Iseb, but once more cancelled out. And Justin Rocas, he is red hot. And Chacon is downed.
You score, we score here on pitch one.
Well, we don't like to see that. He's asking for a card, is Jose Chacon. It's not going to happen. Campos to Chacon. And now here comes Rapunda. No option for the shot on goal. Instead, he has to go back to his captain, Iseb Rapunda. It was well worked by Namibia there. Rocas, can he pick out the pass? He certainly can. Oh, and the effort from Campos was so close. Wrong-footed Kelvin Kok, but it was just wide of the target.
Don't forget, up next on this pitch is the final of the men's plate between Egypt and Ireland. We can just see the Irish boys walking into the stadium there. They mean business. They've been brilliant. But Egypt, what a team, Rory.
Absolutely. That one I cannot call. That is one to sit back and enjoy. It is going to be a thriller to see who will claim the plate title. Well, there is an injury here to, it must be Justin Rocas, and that would be a serious blow for Costa Rica.
It's worth mentioning that if anybody is tuning in a little bit early from Egypt or Ireland, there's your boys in that back corner. You can see them there. And of course, we should, quite frankly, be making household names of power, especially the number seven and captain.
Geegan as well.
Geegan's been fantastic. O'Connell, is it?
O'Connell, the number three.
These are all players that have represented Ireland so well. But Egypt, their first men's team in the tournament. Women last year, of course.
Well, two Namibians slide tackling each other. And that has allowed Chacon to break to Rocas. Well, he did have that knock earlier. Looks to have recovered. Not quite zeroed his sights yet with his shooting. This is Svartbui, challenged by Campos. And now, can the Costa Ricans spring the break through Chacon? A bit short there to Campos. Svartbui! And Rocas is down again. And he was just shoved by the number three, Svartbui. The two number threes clashing, both slight frames. Enjoying, though, the physical battle as they meet. And Chacon loses out and then barges into the back of Rapunda. No free kick given. No complaint, though, from the Namibian player.
But Chacon had two men available there. Didn't use either. Took the shot. Maybe that sort of decision is a sort of thing that might lead this game to penalties.
Chacon. There's an injury now to Rian Svartbui, who's been full of goals in this game. But he doesn't look in a good way. Neither side utilizing their bench just yet. Costa Rica did start with Luis Chavarria.
So we've got Frank O'Connor has tweeted, getting excited now. Come on, Irish Street League in the plate final. Come on, you boys in green. Well, hopefully there'll be a big crowd in Ireland. I know last year we had huge crowds, crowded round televisions all over the country, quite seriously, crowded round laptops, whatever they could find to watch this stream and watch the boys in green in the plate final, which they lost 6-4 to Bulgaria in Amsterdam 2015.
Back it comes to Alvarez. 6-6 on pitch one with 30 seconds to go. Can somebody pull a rabbit out of the hat and win this third, fourth playoff in the plate competition? Chacon quite happy to go back to the goalkeeper, and with 10 to go, there might be a half chance here for Campos. It hits the post and Chacon will fire over the top. And Tom, we're going to go surely to penalty kicks, as we just saw with Bulgaria and Poland.
It's fantastic. Yet another close result. Yet another two teams so evenly matched. But there is a few seconds left. We have had injuries. There will be some unofficial injury time. Yes. Maybe even up to a minute potentially, but I wouldn't expect that much.
That is a good point. Remember, Justin Rocas was down for a while. His shot blocked, great save by Kelvin Kok. What a hero in the Namibian goal, and surely the referee has to stop this play. The goalkeeper is injured.
But he hasn't. Kok wasn't able to get across. There was almost an own goal in that passage of play. Furious fans around the stadium. That's happened, the goal's gone in. He's called full time. What do we make of that, Rory?
Well, Justin Rocas is the man being congratulated by his teammates, but the Namibians are furious, and I think rightly so. That game should have been stopped because Kelvin Kok in goals was quite clearly injured in goals, and that was such a crucial moment in that game.
You can just see the look on the face of Kelvin Kok. The Costa Rican keeper has gone over to comfort him, but he's down, he's clearly injured. He was unable to cover even his own defender's pass back, let alone that effort. Here should be a replay with any luck.
That was the man, Justin Rocas, with a hat-trick of goals for Costa Rica. But you can see it is Costa Rica, though, that finish third in the plate competition. That equates to 11th place overall, and a good showing from them, Tom.
Very, very good, of course. Costa Rica, a quick, small, zippy side. They've been strong in the tackle, too. Their little number three, he's been talismanic. Fantastic work by Justin Rojas. But you could say they've come 11th in controversial circumstances.
Absolutely. Well, remember, you can donate to the Homeless World Cup by texting GOAL to 70660 for a one-off £5 donation. There's plenty other ways to get involved on social media. Facebook.com/Homeless World Cup. Also on Twitter, tweet at Homeless World Cup, no O in world. And YouTube.com/Homeless World Cup for all the highlights of all the games and all the stories. And use the hashtag HWC2016. Next up, it is a big one. It is between Ireland and Egypt for the men's plate.